Hello my dear students, in previous lecture I have told you that how can you state Gauss's law from how can you state Gauss's law from the electric field intensity. So the total outward flux of the electric field intensity over any closed surface in free space is equal to the total charge enclosed in the surface divided by epsilon naught. How could you calculate? You can calculate by the first equation of the two fundamental postulates of electrostatics in free space. The divergence of electric field intensity is equal to rho by epsilon naught. The curl of electric field intensity is equal to zero. By the first equation, we can find out the Gauss's law by taking the volume integral in each side of the equation. Now, if we take the second equation, the curl of the electric field intensity, how that can be found from it? Just if we take an integral form to calculate it, integrating the curl of electric field intensity, that means if we take integration in both sides of that equation in the previous part, just go on top of that. If we take this equation, integrate in each side of the equation, what can we get? We can get the closed surface integral of the line integral. How can we get it? That is known as the Stokes' theorem. The Stokes' theorem is that if you integrate a curl of a vector, after integration it will be formed closed surface integral. Closed surface, not is closed, it is closed contour. That is contour because that is closed line integral. A line integral is known as a contour. Closed contour of the electric field, and you can see the dot product is here. That has been placed a dot product. The dot product is here, and dl, that is also a vector, and that is equal to zero. So the line integral is performed over the closed contour C bounding an arbitrary surface. Hence C itself is arbitrary. As a matter of fact, the surface does not even enter into, which hazards that the scalar line integral of the static electric field intensity around any closed path vanishes. That means the scalar line integral of any static electric field intensity around any closed path vanishes. How can we understand this, that will be vanished? We can understand it by doing that. I have told you before in some lectures that if an electric field passes through such a closed path like that, the electric field intensity around it will be vanished. How that will be created? That is quite similar to the Kirchhoff's voltage law in the circuit theory, that the algebraic sum of voltage drops around any closed circuit is zero. Now, coming back to the point, to prove this equation, if a question asks to you that to prove this equation, you have to write like this. Another way of saying that electric field E is irrotational, and we see if the scalar line integral of electric field over the arbitrary closed contour C1, C2 is zero, then C1 electric field and C2 electric field, if we take two electric fields there, as we know, electric field is irrotational, that means conservative. Okay, it will conserve, it will not be lost. Okay, so there is a closed path draw in figure 3.1 arbitrary contour. If anything starts from there, there are two closed paths from P1 to P2. There is a closed path of C1 from P2 to P1 is closed path of C2. By taking C1, electric field, that is a line integral, as it is a line, so it is a line integral, so that will be dl, and C2 edl, that will be another dl. Okay, so the two things are there. After that, just this circle is known as the path to P1 to P2, that is P1 to P2, and that is P2 to P1, that is P2 to P1, along C2. entering the minus sign to there, you can just alter these two upper and lower bounds to P1 to P2, and you can say the electric field from this path and electric field from that path are equal. Now, that is the two forms of differential form and integral form of our electric of our electrostatic fields. That is the postulate of electrostatics in free space, that the two are the differential forms that I have told you before, and these two are the integral forms, that after taking the integration we get these two equations out of that. That is the Gauss's law and that is the Kirchhoff's voltage law as it follows. So my dear students, now you would easily understand that what are the postulates of electrostatics in free space and differential from and integral from with this. Thank you very much for being with me. I will give you next lecture of Coulomb's law, that we will give you a large knowledge of electrostatics in